offend your jokes. But I know that someone has to be the strong one. And I have my weak moments. Sometimes I go on my own, but I weep like a baby because when I lost my father, I was 18. I wasn't working, I didn't know how to be a man, but I'm so thankful that the Lord placed granddaddy in my life to fill that void. And he taught me the word of God. Every time I needed advice, he would sit you down and he would talk you weak. He would make sure his message was clear. So I'm so proud to be a part of this family, and I'm so grateful to be grandson of the Bishop of Dyke of Ferguson. Thank you.
Wonderful grandson. Wonderful, but don't touch one thing. To handle social leads to alcoholism, addiction. And so God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, grandchildren. Wonderful, wonderful memories you have of your grandfather. Yes, God is able to strengthen and keep you. Coming now with condolences, and as the family put into the program 3 minutes, and I know Mike and Hanna, the minister, is very, very dangerous. And so brethren, do your best. Do your best. Coming now is our level of Bishop Stanley Ferguson, New Free Community Holiness Church, Bishop Reuben Delaville, Holy Spirit Church of God, and then our Apostle Farman Ferguson, United Faith Ministries. Apostle, I think Pastor Eliakim was Apostle. Pastor in Soldier Road. And so come right up now, brethren. There will have Bishop Stanley Ferguson come. You can come in this order. And then Bishop Reuben Delaville, and then Apostle Ferguson. And then selection by the Sanctuary Choir of Soldier Road, the final church of which our deceased bishop was pastoring.
Good morning. I stand on the protocol that has been established. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, said the Spirit, that they rest from their labor and their works do follow them. It was 17 years ago when my founding pastor, Bishop's brother, the late Reverend E.J. Ferguson, died. I went home to be with the Lord. That Bishop Eliakim Ferguson, he took me under his wings. There was never a church anniversary or a pastor anniversary when it was strong that him and his wife wouldn't stop in the free community. Never send them an invitation, but I was always assured that one of those anniversaries, if not two, they would be in there with us. Freaky Brady, that whenever you see Bishop Eliakim Ferguson, that is your bishop, and respect him in that light. Bishop Ferguson was my mentor, my confidant. A lot of people don't know how close Bishop and I were. It was Bishop Ferguson, as I look at my 1 minute gone. It was Bishop Eliakim who encouraged me to tear down the old free community and to build a new one. Never had it in my mind until he put it in my spirit. And I said to Bishop, Rev. E.J. was trying to get a property there. They had spied us for such a long time. And the man would not sell it. So I can't, if I get out of free grading, there's no room for expansion. He told me that was an E.J. time. This is your time now. Go back to the man again. And I went back. And he released the property to us. All because of the word that Bishop Eliakim put in my spirit. I am convinced, you know, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that Bishop Eliakim Ferguson was an extraordinary man. See, lying in front of us now, this is no ordinary man. He was a man of God. He's a man that inspired me to live for the Lord. He told me that there is no secret what God can't do as long as you live an upright life for God. God will be on your side. I thank God that he came into my life. That he showed me that you truly can live a life peaceful to God right here on this present. I'd like to say in my closing, well done, Sister Dorcas Ferguson. As I visit the house on numerous occasions, I see her as she took care of my bishop. Well done, children. God must have loved Bishop Eliakim very much. It's the family that he placed around him. Take care of him. And then when he went in the hospital, and I went there to visit him, there was his daughter taking special care of him. God always takes care of his own. I believe that Timothy had Bishop Eliakim in his mind. And he said, I fought a good fight. I finished my course. I kept the faith. There is now laid up for me a crown of righteousness. I pray that I also will fight a good fight. I kept the faith. I finished my course. And that I will meet my confident once again as we crown him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Take your rest, Bishop. Your well-deserved rest. The word of God said, right. Blessed are the dead that die in the Lord. Bishop died in the Lord. I want to ask the way that. That's not debatable. He died in the Lord. Henceforth, he has a crown of righteousness.
And Hulan, Hanna, see. in the pastor. Others see in the bishops. My fellow clergymen, family members, and friends. I think it is fair enough for me to say that I have known Bishop Eliakim Ferguson practically all of his life. Since we both shared in the same grandfather genes, so we are well familiar with each other.
Still have a long time to wait because I have a few more years.
to you, Sister Dorcas, and all of the children, grandchildren, be strong and be encouraged, for the morning will come. On behalf of my faithful wife, Elizabeth, and my immediate family, and the church family, we share our most sincere sympathy in your most darkest of worries. May his soul rest.
Protocol. I am a model of Bishop Eliakim Ferguson. So if you all would not mind, just do me a favor and let somebody in this room just give God a shout of praise. One of the things that he would say when I was under his ministry, he would say, "I don't like a dead church." Anybody who knows Bishop Eliakim, let everybody in this room give God a shout of praise. I have so much that I can say, but there is so much more to be said. I would say today, the Bishop Eliakim Ferguson has impacted my life in so many ways. He was my second pastor. The first after I left the island of Exuma, he was the first in my life. He was the one that truly began to mold a young man into ministry. I can tell you that his life has impacted me, his example has impacted me in three ways. First of all, Bishop Eliakim was a family man, and he modeled this. I've never seen a man who loved his wife, loved his children, loved his grandchildren the way he did. And, you know, he did not hold back on this. Even though at times, you know, in ministry, as a pastor, you would be accused that you're looking out for your children. And I've heard those accusations being hurled at him during those times. And he did what he knew best, and that is why we heard what we heard today, because he loved his family. He was a man of integrity. Bishop did things to the letter. He was always very, very concerned about being a man who honored his leadership by reporting on time, always being true to his report. I had those special moments with him. Third thing, he was, if you ever needed a description of the word faithful or faithfulness, you would look at the man, Bishop Eliakim Ferguson. Because of this man, I believe a lot of what I do today is from him. I can tell you that on a Sunday afternoon when you would want to be watching television, relaxing, perhaps some basketball, the Bishop Eliakim would want to go into communities. He would want to go into communities, into homes. And I can tell you, as a result of this man laid before us today, that I perhaps have been in every home in Garden Hills, number one, number two, every home in Kennedy subdivision, every home in Redland Acres, because this man was passionate about ministry. And for this cause, this same passion burns in my life today. I give God praise because Bishop Eliakim Ferguson was one of those who didn't need the accolades, but he served. And he served well. I was mentored by him. I'm ashamed that I did not have more time with him in life and really to honor him the way he should be honored. But I can say this today, that I was blessed to have him visit our ministry several times. And he visited because he believed in me, because he saw the hands of God on my life. And he would say to me, "Son, you are doing a great job, and I am so proud of you." I had the opportunity to visit him while he was in hospital just once. And then I made a promise that I would cook my famous pumpkin soup, and came back to bring him the pumpkin soup, that I recognized after taking a little sip, he still wasn't able to swallow it. I'm thankful for the opportunity to have known Bishop. On behalf of my dear wife, who would be here today, on Monday while we were celebrating our 30th wedding anniversary, her own dear mother passed away. And so she sends her love and her condolences on behalf of the fine people of United Faith Ministries. We offer our condolences and sincere prayers. I am excited by what I see today because of the legacy Bishop has left. Boy, we can say that the devil has got trouble on his hand. God bless you.